Discussing the approach to increasing on-site work, the launch pad is ready for Artemis I, and new findings from an Earth-observing mission. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. During a virtual Ask the Administrator town hall on May 6th, NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine and other agency leaders spoke about NASA's approach to the possible increase of on-site work at NASA centers and facilities. The administrator stressed that the safety of the NASA workforce continues to be the highest priority of what is expected to be a methodical, careful transition back to on-site work. Currently, NASA is still operating under a large-scale mandatory telework policy with limited on-site work for mission essential activities, including the upcoming launches of the Mars Perseverance rover and our commercial crew flight test with SpaceX to the International Space Station. After several years of upgrades and modifications, historic Launch Pad 39B at our Kennedy Space Center in Florida is ready to support our uncrewed Artemis I mission. The upgrades and modifications will enable the Apollo and Shuttle era launch pad to accommodate our massive Space Launch System rocket and Orion spacecraft. Orion will fly around the moon and back on Artemis I as part of NASA's lunar exploration goals. Data from ICESat-2, the most advanced Earth-observing laser instrument NASA has ever flown in space, have been used to determine that the net loss of ice from Antarctica, along with Greenland's shrinking ice sheet, has been responsible for more than a half inch of sea level rise between 2003 and 2019. The study, which also used data from the original ICESat mission, found that the average yearly amount of ice sheet lost in Greenland and Antarctica each was enough to fill 400,000 Olympic-sized swimming pools, hundreds of times over. NASA climatologist and author Claire Parkinson of our Goddard Space Flight Center has been named as a finalist for a 2020 Samuel J. Heyman Service to America Medal. She is being recognized for work that includes breakthrough scientific research on how changing sea ice coverage in the Arctic and Antarctic oceans has played a significant role in climate change. The SAMMYs, as the award is commonly referred to, recognizes outstanding federal employees who serve the public good and are addressing many of our country's greatest challenges. NASA, the European Space Agency, and the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency invite you to participate in the Global Space Apps COVID-19 Challenge May 30th and 31st. Virtual teams will use open data during this hackathon to propose solutions to COVID-19-related challenges, from studying the coronavirus and its spread to the impact it is having on the Earth system. For more details, check out spaceappschallenge.org. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.